What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 10, the ultimate Let's Play Bassmasters Classic. We have left the warm weather of Lake Ronkonkoma behind us, and today we begin a new tournament here on the icy waters of Sydney Lake. And before we get started, I want to make sure I am as prepared as I can be here. May even want to venture into looking into a new engine here. I know I got a new one for winning the last tournament, but maybe I could trade it in for an even better one. I could potentially get this one, so I will. So I think really all that does is help me maneuver a little bit better in the water or faster. I think I'm already good in terms of everything else. Lures and all that. I've got the best fish finder out there. I think we've made that abundantly clear. Want to make sure I have the 100-pound line, which I do, because if you recall, last time I said there was a monster fish in this lake. And I was not kidding. We're actually going to be going after that first thing. Just want to see if this guy has anything useful to say. But really, nothing I don't already know. So let's get started. Now, hopefully, this will not take me too long. But I do know where I have to go, and it's actually in a little hidden area. I have to bypass a lot of rocks to get there. As you can see, this new engine's helped me move a lot faster. But, as you see, it's kind of a dead end here, but we go down through these rocks, we can actually make our way through. If I don't get hung up here, there's a hidden area, not even shown on the map, where the monster fish is supposed to be swimming around somewhere. So, let me find a nice spot, see if I can find it on my fish finder. And hopefully I can make this quick. Now, I've seen videos where they've used different lures. I don't know if the spoon bait is going to be the best one for the job, but we'll see. Gotta make sure could find it somewhere around here. I believe I have the proper fishing line equipped because this guy is going to be huge and I want to make sure my line can handle it. So far not seeing a trace of him. And hopefully, like I said, this won't take too much time. I don't want to be stuck here searching for a fish, because I think the only fish around here is the monster fish. I think he ate everything else. I'm gonna try casting out again. I don't know if he switches position anytime you cast, like the rare Pokemon of Gold and Silver. Kind of feel like I'm on the orca in the movie Jaws, searching for the big shark, and listening to Quint tell his stories of when he was on the USS Indianapolis. Yeah, I've seen that movie so many times. I think I've got that little monologue of his memorized. Let me see if I remember it. Japanese submarine slammed two torpedoes into our side, Chief. We was coming back from the island of Tinny the Lady, just delivered the bomb, the Hiroshima bomb. 1,100 men went into the water. Vessel went down in 12 minutes. Didn't see the first shark for a half an hour. A tiger, 13-footer. You know that when you're in the water, Chief? You tell by looking from the dorsal to the tail. What we didn't know was our bomb mission had been so secret, no distress signal had been sent. They didn't even list us overdue for a week. Very first light, Chief, sharks come cruising, so we formed ourselves into tight groups. You know, it was kind of like old squares in battle, like you see in the calendar in the Battle of Waterloo, and the idea was the shark comes to the nearest man, he starts pounding and hollering and screaming. Sometimes the shark go away, sometimes he wouldn't go away. Sometimes the shark looks right into your eyes. That's the thing about a shark, he's got lifeless eyes, black eyes, like a doll's eyes. Doesn't really seem to be living until he bites you. Those black eyes roll over white and, oh, you hear that terrible high-pitched screaming. The ocean turns red, and in spite of all the pounding and hollering, they all come in and rip you to pieces. You know, by the end of that first dawn, we lost 100 men. I don't know how many sharks, maybe 1,000. I don't know how many men, the average chicks an hour. Thursday morning, Chief, I bumped into a friend of mine, Herbie Robinson from Cleveland. Baseball player, bosun's mate. Thought he was asleep, reached over to wake him up. Bobbed up and down on the water just like a kind of top. Upended. Well, he'd been bitten in half the below the waist. Noon the fifth day, Mr. Hooper. Lockheed Ventura saw us. He came in low and he saw us. He was a young pilot, a lot younger than Mr. Hooper. Anyway, he came in low, he saw us. And 3 hours later, a big fat PBY comes in, starts to pick us up. You know, that was the time I was most frightened, waiting for my turn. I'll never put on a life jacket again. So 1,100 men went into the water. 316 men come out. The sharks took the rest, June the 29th, 1945. Anyway, we delivered the bomb. You know, you've seen that movie way too many times when you've got that monologue memorized damn near verbatim. But yeah, it looks like the monster fish didn't eat all the fish in this area. There's a pike swimming around. I did want to switch lures, though. I'm trying a different one here. I recall seeing a video on YouTube of a guy playing this game using this particular lure to try and catch the monster shark. And it actually seems to be working a little better. As long as I keep moving it from side to side, I can keep it on the bottom of the floor. But so far, all I'm finding is that pike, and that's not going to do me any good. I'm going to try and cast again. This time I know I've got the correct line. I've got the 100-pound test line on right now. I heard the beep. You know, it's got to be around here somewhere. We're already an hour and a half into this tournament, and I've got bupkis right now. So, hope this guy shows up soon, or else, I might be in a bit of a bind when I try to catch up with everybody. Yeah, I want to stay focused here. Just trying to do a bit of a sweeping motion on the floor here to see if he's anywhere nearby. I know I heard the beep. It was around here somewhere. I hope I'm just not embarrassing myself by chasing something that's not here. He's got to be here, otherwise, why would this secret pond be here? It's not even showing up on our map. Really, if you look at the map of this lake, you'll see that it shows me like I'm actually on land, but this is definitely not land that I'm on. Didn't want to cast there. I also don't want to have to reel in so much line. The lesser line I have to reel in, the better. Show me the way to go home. I'm tired and I wanna go to bed. I had a little drink about an hour ago, and it's gone right to my head. Wherever I may roam, by land or sea or foam, you will always hear me singing this song. Show me the way to go. Holy sh! Look at the size of that mother. This is the monster fish. This has got to be it. Let me get in position here. Come on, take this one. Okay, I got him. This guy's going to fight me, so I got to focus here. Don't want to reel too fast. Maybe if I can get him to breach. He breached, but not a lot. Good thing I got the 100-pound line on, or else this would not be going as well as it is. But he's close. He's only a dozen feet away. Got him to breach again. I think he's tired. We landed him. And this was a monster. I mean, it's got teeth. Look at that. Made the front page of the Angler Times. Look at that. A whopping 34-pound, 9-ounce fish. And just like that, with one catch, I catapult to the top of the leaderboard. Now, I got the fish. Now I gotta get the hell out of here. And it's easier said than done. Remember, bypass a bunch of rocks here, so I gotta angle the boat just right, because if I can't get out, I'm stuck here and I can't get back to the docks in time for a weigh-in. Then all my efforts today would have been for naught. I would be DQ'd for the day. I'm so close. Get through here. I'm almost out. I just gotta get over this last little reef here. It's got me by the tail end here. Come on. Gotta jimmy loose here. Alright, I'm out. Okay, so we caught the monster. Now we can actually fish for real. And since I'm here, I'll, probably find a spot around here that's got a lot of fish. So something other than the spoon bait actually came in handy here. So let's see if I can catch some more fish with it. I mean, I've already got an edge. I've basically got a whole live well worth of fish right now, but only one catch, so I can put four more in there. So I could potentially have a 50, maybe 60-pound day here, depending how the rest of the day goes. I see a bass back there, but he looks like he's too far out. Well, he looks like he's turning around, maybe. That or I got dirt on my screen here. Oh, here we go. Here's something that's closer. But is he going to come to us? No, he's swimming away from us. Seems to be circling, but he's keeping his distance from us. So it doesn't look like he's going to be coming to us anytime soon. Well, maybe he's coming. And he's turning away again. Dang. Let's see. You know what? That lure got me the monster, but I'm just going to go back to my old gear, my 40-pound line, and my spoon bait. I noticed some guys around here. Maybe if I approach it from this end, maybe I'll have better luck catching them. Alright. Oop. It's a small one, but it's a little too high up for the spoon bait. Although it's starting to come down near the seafloor here. Although that fish is coming away from us. Oh, here's a bigger one. This one may be more worth our while here. Oh, got him. All right, let's bring this guy in. After catching that monster, this should be a cakewalk. Despite the fact I'm not using the super strong line anymore. Same strategies apply. Try and get him to breach. Don't let the line get too tight. Just reel him in. Okay, now I gotta hope this fish doesn't get eaten by that monster in my live well. 7 pounds, 6 ounces, that's a great catch. Let's see, Clyde Casey, Willie Emerson, currently battling for second and third right now. And we really haven't even explored much of this lake as either, so I think we're gonna look around a bit. Maybe test our luck in other parts of the lake here. Let's see what's around this part. We're still on the northern side of the lake. We really haven't explored the southern side yet. I will try and get to that later in the day. Really, I'm kind of on a high right now because I caught that monster. I know I'm going to get a big bonus at the end of the tournament for landing that sucker. Screwing with me right now, but not having a lot of luck finding these fish. Bear in mind, it's a lot colder at this lake than it was at Ronkonkoma. I think the outside temperature was only in the 40s. I mean, this is like East Coast fishing temperature right now. When I was on that disastrous boat trip I mentioned a couple episodes ago, it was, well, it was early in the morning for one, but it was also, 40 degrees with a lot of wind when you're on the water, and it gets drastically colder as you get onto the water. Oh, and that's a trout. I almost let that guy take my bait here. I don't want a trout. But yeah, when you're on the water, it is drastically colder than it is on land. So you gotta be prepared for that kind of thing if you ever go on a fishing trip. And go on the water. You're about a mile off the coast. I'll see where everybody is here. Yeah, still got a pretty commanding lead. I mean, that one fish alone has trumped second and third place here. Well, let's go to the southern part of the lake here. We haven't explored that part yet. It's pretty wide open out here. Actually, it seems to be a bit warmer down here as well. Water temperature is 60 degrees. Maybe I'll have a little better luck with it being a little bit warmer. Maybe they'll be more tuned to come out here. But I don't want the trout. I want the bass. I just hope all the other competitors haven't completely fished the lake dry here, because they've already got a lot of pounds of fish. Just the top 10. Although I got the monster. I see a bass here. Looks like a small one, but it'll do for now. Now don't turn around. Come back. Alright. Well, you'll do for now. It is definitely a small catch. Hope it's not too small. So what do we got here? We got a little 1 pound 14 ounce sucker. Doesn't even qualify. Alright, so wow, we're at the halfway point of the day already. Wonder how long it took me to actually catch that monster. Still got half a day of fishing left, but I technically only have two fish to my credit right now, despite the fact I am winning this whole tournament. I gotta get away from the pike. Jeez Louise. Another pike, don't want that. Is this a trout or a bass? Oh, that's a trout. Don't want that. I think I would have recognized that when it got that close. I don't know what's going on with me today. Well, right now I'm finding everything but what I want to find here. Up there you are. Trying to catch you from the back. They got another, looks like a trout in the background. And please be enough to make the live well. That same fish? Well, it's no good to me, so I'm gonna throw it back. Maybe I'm just not looking in the right spots here. I guess these later lakes, the good fish are harder to come by. Because now it's starting to look like I needed that big one to actually do some damage in this tournament. I don't want that to be the case. I mean, I want to have at least 50 pounds of my live well before day's end. If I can do that, I'll be happy. But I need to start catching some more fish. Don't want the trout. Don't want the pike. I don't know, I'm getting kind of humbled right now. I mean, if I didn't catch that monster, I would probably be not even in the top 10, which would put, honestly, this whole LP in jeopardy of me being able to complete it, because I gotta finish in the top 3. So it's a good thing I got what I have now. Where have all the bass gone? No. Trout and the pike, they're everywhere here, but I think I got a bass here coming up. But I don't want that pike to get in the way. There we go. This looks like a big one. Alright, so finally we're starting to make some progress here, if I can reel this guy in. This guy looks like he's at least 5.5 pounds. Alright, we got him. Let's add this guy to the live well. We'll tack on another 5 pounds, 4 ounces, 2 hour total. Puts us at 47.3 for the day. We still have 2 slots left in our live well. So let's keep going. I know it's noon. I know it's lunchtime, but we've got, well, bigger fish to fry here. And I don't mean fry technically, I mean catch. Just trying to use euphemisms here. And they're not working. Okay, we've officially hit high noon. And that trout came out of nowhere, almost took my bait. Don't want the pike. It's a lot of trout and a lot of pike in this lake, I've noticed. They seem to outpopulate the bass. And they're all hungry. And just trying to avoid these pikes are really starting to get on my nerves a bit. And there's a bass, but swimming away from us. And this pike is hounding me right now. Yeah, I don't care if it's a small one. I just want to catch this guy. Hopefully he'll make the live well, unlike my last couple of small ones. Okay. It's another 1 pound, 14-ouncer. Really, I swear, everybody else caught all the big ones, or I don't know what. This may be the first time I finish a day of fishing and not have a full live well, despite having the lead. It was all thanks to that monster catch. Like I said, I'm probably going to be seeing some serious coin for that at the end of the tournament. Caught the legendary monster of Sydney Lake. At this rate, any bass above 2 pounds is good. To be fully honest with you, I don't even know if I've explored this whole lake. Probably a trout. That didn't look like the shadow of a bass there. Aha, here we go. Gotta get in better position though. It's another small one. I'm just hoping you're not 1 pound, 14 ounces. Another one back. All right, we got him. All right, he makes the live well. 2 pounds, 1 ounce. Puts me at 49.4 for the day. Clyde Casey in second, Willie Emerson in third. Still got couple hours left on the water that we can spend here. I'm hearing a lot of beeps around here, so hopefully it's not all just trouts and pikes. Well, there's one trout. Where's the bass? There's a bass, and that looks like a big one. Let the lure sink. He's coming to me. Get away from me, trout. You're not wanted. Alright. This guy's gonna make the live well. This will actually fill my live well, have my limit of 5 fish. If I can get him into the boat. Seems to be fighting me a bit here. He's not breaching, but he's also wearing himself out pretty quickly here. Okay. Made me work for that, but ultimately, I gotcha. 6-6. Not bad. 55-10 on the day. I now have a full live well, so I'm feeling much better now. It's 1 o'clock. Should probably start heading back. I'll see if I can possibly tack anything else onto my live well once I get closer to the docks. Hearing a lot of commotion around here, so let's check this area out one more time. Pike almost grabbed my bait there. That would have not been good. What do we got coming up here? This looks like a bass. Oh, there's a big one. And he actually took it before anybody else could. Actually, a couple of bass down there. Okay. But I think I got the biggest one of the bunch, so can't complain about that. I'll be throwing that little 2-pounder back. Let's see what this guy's gonna measure up to. Alright, let's get a measurement here. This bass, 7 pounds, 4 ounces. A nice catch indeed. I am now over 60 pounds on the day. In one day of fishing, I've caught 60 pounds of fish. And I will say this, the four smaller fish in my live well are still combined smaller than the monster that I caught earlier. So think about that. And I'm surprised the monster fish hasn't eaten everything on my live well right now. Because that guy had teeth. Looks like I got a couple potential strikes here, but question is, are they big ones? That one doesn't seem to be these guys both looked small here, so it's probably not going to make the live well, but I'll reel them in. That's not to waste my lure. Kind of getting protective of my spoon baits. Again, they've been my key to success so far in every tournament I've been in. Although I think we can make an exception in this day's events here, as we use a different lure to catch the monster. Alright, this one's probably going to go back in the water. This thing measured in a flat 2 pounds, but does not meet the 5-pound, 4-ounce minimum that I have in my live well right now. So unless it's a big bass, I'm probably not going to go for it. Made it back to the docks, I believe. Yeah, I have. Noticing a few beeps around here, so maybe I got time for another cast, so I'll go ahead and check it out. May very well be my last cast of the day. We're coming up on the 2 o'clock hour, which is usually about when I start to wrap things up for the day. And with 60 pounds in my live well, I think I've done more than my fair share of damage today. The fish finally started biting during the later hours of the day. And good thing, because I was getting a little bored catching all the small ones here. But I got one of everything here, but luckily I got the big bass here. So let's see if I can add to the live well what little room I have left in there. I don't know how you would legitimately put 60 pounds of fish in one live well, but then again, I've never fished professionally, so I'd have to actually see a live well in person to know for sure. Well, I know you can't even probably put a 35 pound fish in there if you catch it. You see some of these fishermen get these big marlins, these big groupers, tunas, you know? Those things are just massive. Let's see what we got here. 5 pounds, 4 ounces does not meet the requirements, though. It's actually tied for my smallest fish, so we're going to be throwing it back. That was a bummer, too, because that was a nice-sized old boy there. Well, I think I've done enough for the day. I'm going to go ahead and head to the weigh-in, and we'll end day one of the Sydney Lake Tournament. Let's see where everyone else stands. It looks like Clyde Casey in second, Will Yemerson in third. And I've got a massive lead over both of them. Now that little photo of me on the left does not do the monster fish justice. But I'm going to call it quits here. We'll continue the Sydney Lake Tournament in the next episode. Until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.